Wearing a smartwatch or carrying a smartphone during our fitness activities are a trend now, as it can help us track our fitness goals. It has also saved many lives with its cardiography, fall detection, and other useful features. A similar technology is being used in the equipment industry, like pumps, to harness the data from the equipments for a holistic approach. First impression seems fantastic, right? But it is a bitter truth that it is still not receiving much of an attention from the end users. Today, we are going to discuss about the pump Internet of Things, smart sensors, its benefits, why it is still a no-no to pump users, and 4 tips on how to consider your right sensor. Hello everyone, this is Karthik and welcome to the Pump Universe. Let us jump in. A smart sensor, or an Internet of Things sensor, is a device that can communicate with a digital cloud platform, and this communication can be harnessed for various purposes. Let's look at its working principle in detail. Firstly, the smart sensor communicates with a gateway or the smartphones via the compatible communication protocol, be it wireless, Bluetooth, etc., and transmit the stored data. Then these data are transmitted to the cloud with the help of the internet, and the computed data can be viewed either through the app interface in your smartphones or the web interface in your computer. The web interface is a special platform where you can manage these assets, set roles for the users, and do various other device management. Benefits of these sensors could include condition monitoring, predictive maintenance, and also generating a digital twin. Let's look at each of them in detail. Condition monitoring. The pump IoT sensors are capable of measuring the triaxial vibrational data and the skin temperature on a regular basis. These data can be diagnosed, monitored, and analyzed at the cloud platform. The threshold feature in the sensor helps to give the vital alerts to the user in case of any abnormal vibration or temperature issues during the operation. Hence, these data and alert messages can be extremely valuable to processes where you can take swift action during their short reactive phases. The analysis of the cloud platform does not end with just condition monitoring. With their capability of capturing the specific patterns of the equipments based on available analytical tools, and with wealth of digital database available in the cloud platform, these sensors can provide valuable predictions like when the parts such as bearings will fail, when is the next lube oil schedule, what is the mean time between failure of these equipments. Hence, it can help the maintenance team to plan ahead for the next maintenance schedule, also making sure that the essential parts and utilities are available, thereby providing enough room for saving their time and cost. Hence, this is the feature that really sets this sensor apart from the traditional condition monitoring sensors. Now let's look at the digital twin. I always enjoy watching this Indian movie, Jeans, where the lead actress Aishwarya Rai has a digital twin which she uses to play tricks on her fiancé's family. I never realized that later that the digital twin technology would become a cornerstone for the equipment industry's digital transformation. It is a basis for continuous improvement and thereby providing a better value proposition to the user. They have 3 segments: digital twin of product, digital twin of a production, digital twin of a performance. Digital twin of a product. Till a decade ago, if we propose a new pump model that is under beta phase, it always includes the prototype, engineering, manufacturing, and testing cost. Because of its additional cost, it could either become a lost opportunity or could lead us observe this cost to earn this order. Of course, for a better aftermarket opportunity. But now, with the advent of analysis, simulation softwares of a product, the product can now be prototyped in the virtual environment. Hence, it could save lots of engineering time and prototype cost. This mathematical model, or the digital model, will now be the digital twin of the developed product. Now let's look at the digital twin of the production. After the product development phase, you can now determine the right process for manufacturing this product in the virtual world itself using the product model information. The finalized process will now be the digital twin of the production. Then the real production can be initiated. After the product is successfully developed, tested, and sent to site, pump IoT sensor will now be responsible for their performance. When the sensor sends the data to the cloud, the cloud platform stores them under its identity, and this database will act as a digital twin of performance of the product. It will have information such as vibration spectrum during normal operation, failure modes, optimum operational zones, maintenance schedules, etc. These valuable information could help the subject asset or equipments, or the similar equipments installed in the similar environments. Hence, it can provide the necessary predictive analytics to increase the mean time between repair duration. Retrofits and overhauls will now be more productive, as the maintenance engineer or service engineer will get first-hand information without spending much of their time and effort on tracing these documents. And it also facilitates a better understanding of the failure modes of the product. These three digital twins are interdependent on each other, and their iterative process helps each other. Hence, the end result is the continuous improvement of the product, production, and performance. By now, you must be thinking, wow, these sensors are really cool and provides much of a value proposition. But believe it or not, it is still not picking up the pace that we want it to be. So why there is so much of hesitation or resistance to purchase these sensors? Let's look at some of the possible reasons. First possible reason could be due to fear of data theft. Companies with intellectual properties or proprietary processes or products always care about their data security. Hence, they will have a fear of putting this data onto the cloud. But do not feel too much worried about it, as protecting the data is one of the highest priority of these service providers. And the pump IoT sensor manufacturers have always tied up with platforms that have proven track records. I'm especially excited to see equipment industry pioneers like Siemens, who have come up with a platform called MindSphere, which offers a great IoT OS package. I can't wait to see what immense benefits that this sort of IoT OS platform offers to the pump users. Treating them as traditional sensor. While the hardware of the traditional sensor and smart sensor are quite similar, it is the firmware and its ability to communicate with a cloud that sets them apart. The purpose of a smart sensor go well beyond than just collecting the data and providing the alert. It is about harnessing them for a holistic approach that is beyond human intervention. Looking for a short-term ROI with these sensors. So using them as just a condition monitoring tool will not provide the much-needed ROI. These sensors are meant to be in a long-term relationship with the equipment and provide analytics to that equipment and also to its similar equipments. That's all for possible reasons. Now let's look at the tips to choose the right sensor. Tips to choose the right sensor. There are several pump sensors available in the market right now. A lot of them are pretty good. So it is always tough to choose the one that is appropriate for your application. So here are the few tips to help you make that decision. Tip number one, quality of service. On time, receipt of data packets are always crucial for taking necessary actions in the equipments. So choosing the sensor that can cater to your response time should be the first criteria. For this case, we also have to understand a term called latency. Latency reflects the time it takes for the data to go from the source to the destination. So the sensor with high latency takes longer time to send the data, but also observes less battery power. Bluetooth protocol is an example of a high latency sensor. Whereas low latency means shorter time for transmitting the data packets, but it also comes at the cost of battery life. Wireless sensor comes in this category. So choose your sensor based on the quality of service requirement. There is also this connectivity-based challenges in the gateway. If the installation has a better Wi-Fi coverage or 4G signal coverage, it is always practical to rely on them. But the wired gateways, although difficult to be installed in most of the sites, always have a better transmission rate. In this scenario, it is also good to point out that most of the sensor providers are exploring the signal through LoRaWAN or narrowband IoTs. LoRaWAN is a protocol responsible for transmitting just the binary information. Hence, its frequency does not interfere with any other signal. So this long-range, low-power, wide-area coverage protocol can transmit the binary information in kilometers without any issues. Because of their long-range, wide-area coverage capability, LoRaWAN can be installed at sites where you have network coverage issues. But then, this comes with a relatively high latency feature. So an alternative cellular network like narrowband IoTs or NB IoTs that could provide faster data packets but consume low power are also key to standardize the IoT devices so that they become more reliable and provide a good quality of service. So in future, we could see most of the sensor providers switching over to either LoRaWAN or NB IoT protocols for their sensors based on their quality of service needs. Tip number 3. Budget-based criteria. If your site has less than 5 pumps and are in regular human accessible area, then it is wiser to install a Bluetooth sensor which is cheaper and needs just a smartphone to push the data to the cloud. Some sensors also have features such as local alert lights to enable the end users to use them as a local alert system so that they can test these sensors prior to upgrading them with a data cloud system. After all, we need our users to take these small steps that makes a big difference in their system. Tip number 4. Cloud platform capabilities. It is very, very important to understand the basics of your service provider's cloud platform capabilities as it is where your data is computed and analyzed. A reliable cloud computing system is a long-term investment. In conclusion, I hope you have now understood the basics of PUMP Internet of Things or smart sensors, their capabilities, and hopefully that these guidelines will help you to choose a right sensor for your application. If you have enjoyed this video, please like, share, and comment. If you'd like to receive similar content from this channel, please subscribe to PUMP Universe. Take care. Bye-bye.